Alright, yo guys, what's going on? It's Sore Rage, and welcome back to some Black Ops Cold War. Here for today's video, I unlocked Diamond on all of the snipers, and I wanted to share what attachments I was using on them throughout my time of leveling them up and getting them to gold. One quick thing I wanted to mention, though, is that a lot of the attachments I use on the snipers go hand-in-hand with each other, and you'll definitely want to have them maxed out in order to get the most benefit out of them. However, I do take a lot of time in describing all of the attachments, especially the ones that I used for leveling them up, so if you're looking for a specific weapon, for example, be mindful of the timestamps down in the description below. And also, feel free to go ahead and let me know down in the comments if you all are enjoying Cold War and what your thoughts on the sniping are so far. Hope you all enjoy the video. So the first sniper I wanted to talk about today is the Barrett, the M82, and honestly, it is such a shame how horrible this thing is. So real quick to go ahead and run through the attachments, I've been using this Axial Arms, I'm sorry if I'm saying that wrong, 3x scope. You guys will definitely hear me talk more about this later, but the Hangman RF scope is a scope that I would recommend a lot of the time because it does make it seem like you aim down sight a lot faster on all of the snipers with it. And also, if you're somebody like me being an old school Call of Duty player, if you guys like the more black scope as compared to the dual render, this Ultra Zoom Custom does give you that old school feel to it, which is really cool. Personally, for the most part though, I have been sticking to the Hangman RF, but here on the Barrett, considering how slow it is, I've just stuck with the Axial Arms. For the barrel here, it's also a very common thing to have the 22.6 inch Tiger Team barrel on all of the snipers because it increases the damage, fire rate, and bullet velocity. But all the way up until this point, I was using the 22.6 inch Combat Recon barrel just because it increases that bullet velocity, and I know a lot of people probably use that fire rate, but because it's a Barrett, I don't really see too much of a need for it. One thing that I would definitely recommend while you're ranking up the Barrett is to be playing a lot of combined arms in the whole 12v12 game mode, and considering how huge those maps are, if you're sitting back sniping, which honestly is the more effective way to use the Barrett in this game, I just kept on the higher bullet velocity so you wouldn't have to account for so much bullet drop. I didn't really mess around too often with the muzzle, body, or underbarrel personally, although I feel like this is a given. If you're somebody who's posting up in the back of the map, obviously go ahead and just run the bipod because it gives you a lot of that recoil control. In the earlier levels of the Barrett, I was using more of the steady aim laser just because a lot of the time on these close quarters maps, you're not going to have a whole lot of time to scope in with the Barrett, so sometimes you might have to get away with spraying away a couple of shots from hip fire, so steady aim is probably the best way to go about that. As far as magazines go, the one that I've been using is the 7 round, but you also could use the fast mag if you really want that sleight of hand feel to it. With every other magazine, I would not recommend using really any of these because they take away so much time on the aim down sight when the Barrett is already slow enough. And speaking of the aim down sight time, the one grip that I would highly recommend using once you get your weapon up to level 53 is this Airborne Elastic Wrap because it does give you a 12% aim down sight increase. In the earlier levels, I stuck with a speed tape just because it gives you that 5%. The drop shot wrap and the field tape, I didn't really bother using, but once you get the Sasser, probably saying that wrong, as soon as you get the Sasser jungle grip and the serpent wrap, and then once you get it to level 53, all of these grips are good. And this goes for all of the snipers, by the way. And now here for the stock, I feel like having a good stock is actually the most beneficial on the Barrett as compared to the Tundra or the Pellington just because it's already so slow. In the earlier levels, I was using the Marathon stock because it gives you a 10% sprint to fire time, and now here in the later levels, I'm using the CQB pad. As soon as I get the Barrett to level 54, I'm gonna go ahead and switch it out to the Raider pad. This is obviously the best stock in the game that gives you a 30% increase to sprint to fire time. So now to go ahead into details, once you get this Airborne Elastic Wrap, the aim down sight time is 616 milliseconds. Even though throughout a solid majority of the time while I was using the Serpent Wrap, it's at 630 milliseconds. Sasser Jungle Grip, it's at 644. Then here with the Speed Tape, it's still really slow at 665. And now again, the reason why I was saying the stocks are so important here is because yesterday there was another patch that came out for the snipers where they increased the sprint to fire time on all of the snipers from 400 milliseconds to 450 milliseconds. It might not honestly seem like much, but when you're running out of that sprint trying to bring your scope up or even just trying to hip fire, those little milliseconds go a long way. And it looks like here on the Barrett, if you go between the CQB pad and the Raider pad, it doesn't change the sprint to fire time, but if you do want that aim walking movement speed like you're walking around in your scope, then it'll help. For those of you guys that didn't already know this, the Barrett without any ADS attachments has a 700 millisecond aim in time, which is again the slowest it has ever been in Call of Duty. So again, long story short, if you're somebody like me who likes to run around a quick scope, you absolutely need all of the ADS that you can possibly get on the Barrett. And now here with the Pellington and the Tundra, a lot of the attachments are already the same as they pretty much are across all the sniper rifles, but here on the Pellington with no ADS attachments, it's at 550 milliseconds, and again, like I was saying earlier, the sprint to fire time got buffed to 450. If you want the absolute fastest, go ahead and use the Airborne because it brings it down to 484 4, but with the Serpent, you still keep more of that sprint to fire time. Same thing like I was saying here with the Barret, go ahead and be sure you guys are using the Raider pad so you guys get that extra sprint to fire time. Exact same thing, Tiger Team Barrel, 7-round magazine, and again, the Hangman RF Optic. And now lastly, my favorite sniper in the game so far is the Tundra, and its default ADS time is 650 milliseconds. I haven't unlocked the Airborne Elastic Wrap, so I've just been sticking with the Serpent Wrap. It brings it up to 585 milliseconds. And now here's one attachment that I've seen a whole lot of people using. This Tiger Team Spotlight is something that, if you guys remember from Modern Warfare 3, the perk Marksman Pro, how you would be able to spot enemies at a further distance and it would show their nameplate and everything. Here in Black Ops Cold War, it just puts a little dot over their head. If you're playing on much larger maps, I would go ahead and recommend using this, but for the most part, considering how small these maps are, you don't really need to use it. It really just comes down to what game modes you're playing the most. Again, especially if you're playing a lot of 6v6, I really don't feel like you need it. I still haven't unlocked the Raider pad, but again, stick with the Marathon stock if you don't already have it. Serpent Wrap, 7-round mag, 26-inch or 28-inch Tiger Team barrel on this. And now lastly here again for the Optic, the Hangman RF scope. But if you are somebody that does really want to use that Tiger Team Spotlight for that Marksman Pro effect, you guys can probably just go ahead and run a reg scope on the LW3 Tundra. It's still pretty solid as is. So now that all the attachments are out of the way, the last camo that I have to get unlocked for all of the snipers is gold, or I just have to finish off this last psychedelic challenge, which is just getting double kills. I have to get 3 more double kills here on the Barrett. I have to get 10 more on the Tundra, and again, 2 more on the Pellington. But I wanted to go ahead and also take a quick second to talk about the challenges, because the challenges in this game are not hard. The biggest problem is that as of right now, it has taken so long to max out all of these weapons to even get the tiers of camos. So here for the spray challenges, it's just get 200 eliminations with it. Here for the stripes, it's just 50 headshots. Here for classic, you just need bloodthirsties, 20 bloodthirsties. You get those pretty naturally. Here with geometric, you get 50 long shot medals. Again, play a lot of 12v12 for that. It's very, very simple. Here for the flora challenges, it also comes extremely simple because it's just 50 kills holding your breath. Here for the science challenges, I really feel like this should have been like one of the first ones you get because it's 50 one-shot kills. You're getting 50 one-shot kills in the first couple of games you're using it anyway. But again, the biggest problem is that you had to wait up until level 40 to get that. And then here again, lastly, psychedelic, you have to get to level 50. Again, like I was saying earlier, I'm second prestige level 55, and pretty much all the way up until this point, I have done nothing but snipe and get these snipers ranked up. It has taken me this long. They've got to do something about the weapon XP in this game. I feel like as of right now, it is way too slow. I've basically been using one sniper per prestige. For a majority of weapons in this game, as far as all of the primaries go, I think they all go to level 55. And if it stays at the current rate, you're going to be using the same weapon, having to get at least, I would say, 900 to 1,000 kills per weapon just to get it up to level 50. It's just going to take so long. All right, now let's go ahead and finally jump into a game here. I felt like I took so much longer describing all of that, but that's the breakdown that I wanted to show you guys or talk about. So again, last week when I was looking through all these Dark Matter challenges, like seeing how it would play out, I was looking at this like, wow, this is going to be really easy to get. But little did I know how long it was actually going to take. Like, I was genuinely not expecting to spend entire prestiges working on just one weapon. Currently, as of right now, though, it's November 21st on Saturday, and I know this upcoming Tuesday, they are supposed to be releasing Nuketown, and I don't know if they're going to do some sort of, like, double XP, double weapon XP, but as soon as Nuketown comes to the game, I really want to go ahead and work on pistols, shotguns, and especially the knife, make some sort of, like, XJMX video like I did a couple of years ago. I feel like that's going to be a really fun video to make. I'm, like, genuinely excited to make that. So again, first sniper we're finishing here is the Barret. I just got to go ahead and quickly get 2 double kills. Hopefully, once I finish these camo challenges, they'll actually stick. But look at this, though. Like, look at this aim down sight time. It's so slow, dude. I really cannot stress enough how horrible this thing is, on top of how slow it is. And now, thankfully, though, Tony Flame did tweet out that the next order of business, apparently, is to give the Barret a buff, which is much, much needed. Although, as far as all the snipers go, I really didn't even see much of a need to nerf them even harder than what they originally were from the beta. I knew that in the alpha, they had intentionally buffed them up to an insane level, and I really liked where they were in the beta. The only thing that they really need to do is just maybe, well, for one, fix the aim assist, but just add flinch to snipers, and then they were golden, in my opinion. Here with the Barret, though, if they really wanted us to, like, post up in the back of the map and snipe, I wouldn't necessarily mind the ADS time on it. Just at least give us, you know, constant one-shots or just something. Okay, maybe not constant one-shots, but, you know, like, something to somehow balance the damage to aim down sight time. Because if you're gonna give us a slow ADS time, you may as well give us a higher damage to it, right? Kind of like how, for example, the Outlaw in Black Ops 4 was stupidly fast, but it was also stupidly weak. The Barret really just does not have that even trade-off of ADS and damage. It's pretty bad. So if you're somebody that's not going for Dark Matter, just completely avoid the Barret. If you don't have to use it, don't use it. Although, honestly, I've spent the last day or two just working on the Barret alone. I'm, like, really excited to see what it's gonna feel like to go back and use the other snipers.
Multiple hostile spy planes detected.
I feel so bad because like a majority of the time I literally just have to stay scoped in. It's also a big reason as to why I recommend using this 3x scope, this Axe Alarms, because it's so much easier to stay scoped in like this. Dude, it's like every time I get one kill, I always end up getting shot in the back. It's so obnoxious.
Hardpoint is secure.
Was that the last one? Please tell me that was the last one. Did that count? No. Apparently it didn't. Okay. I only needed two. Where's my gold? Hello? I don't want to use this thing anymore.
Get the fuck out your-
I literally just spawned, dog. I don't know what you want me to tell you. There we go. Is that it? There we go. Gold camo. Let's go, boys. I don't know why it doesn't show a gold camo preview like it did for Bliss, but okay. I'm so glad I don't have to use this thing anymore because, guys, I really can't stress this enough. Over the past 2 days, like since Thursday night and then all the way up through last night, Friday, I'm just grinding out the Barret so much and it's been such a pain, dude. Like, even if you were to post up in the back of the map, it just still gets so many hit markers. I'm so done with it, dude. All right, Pellington. Going from the slowest sniper into the game to the fastest. This is gonna be interesting. But like, this is what I was talking about on the Pellington though. Like, coming out of the sprint, this Hangman RF scope is stupid. Like, look at that. Although I will say, it does feel very good to quickscope again. It feels so weird going from one extreme to the other. It's like actually, it's kind of messing with me a little bit, I'm not gonna lie. So again, here it is, finally, the Golden Barret. I never have to use this thing again. At least as of right now, while the Barret is just so horrible, it is just really not worth using at all. I'm kind of excited to see what they do with the Barret, but then again, this is Tony Flame. My man, Tony Flame. I know a lot of people aren't the biggest fan of us, quickscoping sniper, glitch scoper, whatever people want to call us nowadays, man. I'm really curious to see, because like, I don't know if he's gonna increase the aim down sight time or if he's going to increase the damage. I think because it's a 50 cal, it should be more focused on damage, but that's just me. For those of you guys that remember my whole fixing the Black Ops 4 snipers video, my biggest point about that I wish I reiterated more in that video is that I would completely understand slower fire rates, like slower fire rates, slower ADS, whatever it may be. There has to be that fair trade-off of damage at least.
Assaulting target.
He's using the Diamond Barret. Oh my god. This man completely outplayed me. Oh, he no-scoped me. Nicely done, gamer. I'm so used to how slow the Barret was. I'm not used to this Pellington at all right now. I can't stress enough how also sick and tired I am of just getting lasered by MP5s, man. It really seems like almost every other death I have in this game is just getting shot in the back with an MP5. Which, that was another thing that I don't think I talked about as far as, like, all the patches go. Oh, hey, look at that! Wow! MP5 in the back! Again, so original. So, apparently what they did in yesterday's patch on Friday was that they had initially nerfed the MP5's damage range or something like that from 15 meters down to 10, and then they accidentally reverted that. So, it was patched, and now it's back to being where it was, and it's still just, it's so stupid right now, man. It's almost kind of like, really, what's the point of using anything else other than the MP5 right now? You may as well just get it ranked up in gold while it's stupid OP anyway. There's a double kill. Finally. Thank you.
Hostile down.
There we go. There's gold camo for the Pellington. How was that not a collat? I don't get it, dude. All right, whatever. L96 time. I need to stop calling it the L96, but that's what it basically is. And which also, that's another thing, dude. Once Nuketown comes to this game, oh yeah, Road to the L96 multi is coming back. For those of you guys that might be new to the channel and aren't familiar with what my Road to the L96 series was, or Road to the L96 multi series was, it's exactly what it sounds like. For some reason, I had this urge to just really hit an L96 multi, having a reload cancel with it, and it was such a pain in the ass. But at the same time, though, it was fun, and it was a clip that I really wanted to hit for a really, really long time. So when I finally hit it, it took me like a year and a half to hit it. Once I finally hit it, that series was just doing, it was so popular on my channel that people wanted me to do it with all the other attachments. So that's what I ended up doing. Honestly, respect to this dude. He's just running around using the Diamond Barret, Reg Scope, and everything. This man is a force to be reckoned with. Finally got the gold Pellington. There we go. I also want to go ahead and try something out real quick again with this Hangman RF scope. I want to go ahead and take this off and I'll switch it out for the Tiger Team Spotlight. Because even for what it is, I really do enjoy just the LW3 Tundra Regiscope. It's the best sniper in this game by a long shot right now. You got all the ADS attachments on it. It's got this like very satisfying feel to it, like you're using the L96 from Black Ops 1. I've got Wallian on my team this time, so he's not gonna clap my cheeks with that Diamond Barrett. Oh, wow, imagine my surprise, shot in the back with another suppressed MP5. Never would have expected that. You guys see that though? How I had like a longer distance and puts that red dot over their head? So that's the point of the Tiger Team Spotlight, but again, on smaller maps, it's not really needed. I cannot wait for this thing to get nerfed, dude. I'm so tired of getting... Oh, I'm so sick of it. It's another thing, man. Like, a majority of the time, by the time that I can't even get my scope up, they've already melted me with, like, half of their magazine. Like, on these 6v6 maps, man, it's just... there's almost even no point to sniping, because you're just getting beamed across the map by an MP5. I just want to know, like, was the jump needed? I don't think so, dude. Oh my god, I hit a Collette.
Two enemies.
And that was almost back-to-back collats. Jeez. You don't need to jump on. Why, dude? I'm so tired of it, man. Oh my goodness. Don't you just love when you're slightly competent in Call of Duty and then you just put in these MLG CDL lobbies where everyone's competing for like, apparently they're competing for $100,000 or something like that. Crazy. Love it.
Hardpoint is secure.
That's a kill. Payback's a bitch.
Was I missing something? Like, was there like $500,000 on the line for this game or something? I don't know, dude. Want to go ahead and try this ultra zoom scope on the Tundra now? I don't know. It looks so goofy, but it looks so cool. Oh my god, this thing looks so... It looks so goofy. Look at this thing. I feel like I'm using the SV-98 from like Battlefield Bad Company 2.
Sniper, take cover.
I might honestly end up just going back to the reg scope because this thing is just really, really weird. Like, the way it scopes in and it, like, snaps, it's like a still snapshot in a sense. Like, I guess it's cool. Maybe I just gotta get used to it. I don't know. Stop jumping. It's not needed. Was that not a double kill either? Maybe it wasn't. I don't know. It's gonna be fine. Your space bar isn't going anywhere. It's there. Don't worry about it. Not going anywhere. Not broken. I don't know. Maybe that's what they're doing this whole time. Maybe they just gotta keep, you know, constantly testing it to be sure that it's not broken.
We are pulling ahead.
Dude, what?
Oh, there it is. Sniper diamond camo. Let's go. I didn't even realize I had that many double kills left. I think I might have only had like one or two, but there we go.
Contesting hardpoint. Hardpoint
blocked. Oh my god.
Oh, no, come on, dude. If I could have turned that into a split quad feed, that would have been really nice. Which, that's also another thing with this game. Like, considering how slow and weak the snipers are, I feel like that's gonna, like, really increase the skill gap when it comes to sniping clips in this game, which is really nice.
Oh. Oh my god.
No, dude. Ugh. That was it. That was the big opportunity of the game right there. And I done goof. I landed that third shot and looked closer to the left. It was done. Over. Easy quad feed, boys. Camo unlock. 000. It looks like I got woodland. This game, man. Oh my goodness. Kind of what I was talking about at the start of the video. Like, even the first video I made on this game, like, everything bugged out. My recordings were corrupted. I'm losing camos. Apparently, I'm unlocking something like woodland as compared to diamond. So here's gold on the Tundra, which I'm gonna go ahead and load into a private match here in just 1 second, but dude, oof, diamond. The gold Tundra in this game seriously gives me some gold L96 vibes, and I absolutely love it. So here we go. Here is the golden Pellington. I absolutely love the weapon inspect on this, like taking the bullet out of the chamber, putting it back in, looks so nice. Now here we've got the gold Tundra. Dude, this is just, it's so pretty. I love this so much. And now we've got the bane of my existence right now, the Barrett, which I still never thought I would see the day that a Barrett would be this terrible in Call of Duty, but it does look very pretty gold. Looks very, very nice. And if you look closely at the diamond, it kind of has like a reactive thing kind of going like how it was in Black Ops 4, which I think is a very nice touch. And now we've got the diamond Tundra. Dude, again, absolutely love the gold scope, love the gold barrel. So pretty, man. As it stands for right now, the Tundra is going to be my main sniper in this game. It is just too good, man. And then lastly here, we've got the diamond Barrett, which looks really nice. I love how like the entire thing is pretty much diamond. That's really nice. I like that a lot. Such a shame, though, that you're such a doo-doo sniper for right now. So anyways, though, guys, on that note, that's gonna go ahead and wrap up my first Black Ops Cold War video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. Currently, as of right now, I'm still trying to figure out what I want to do with this whole Road to Dark Matter Ultra series. I don't know if I want to go through it by weapon, or just do weapon class. I think it really just depends, and just really depends how long it still takes to get all these weapons gold and whatnot, so. Although, I have also talked a lot about this on my live stream, that I do plan on unlocking Dark Aether, I believe it's called, in Zombies. That looks really, really sick. I think it's basically Black Ops 3 Dark Matter, but in this game, so I think that'll also be really fun to go for. Get, like, Pink Diamond on the snipers and whatnot, try and hit some clips with that, make some videos on that. If you guys have any recommendations on what you guys would like to see next for some videos, go ahead and let me know that down in the comment section below. Feel free to also go ahead and join my Discord that's linked down in the description below, so you guys never miss pings on when I post new videos here on YouTube, as well as when I go live on Twitch. Once again, I really hope you all enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you did, subscribe if you're new. It's been Soul Rage, and I will talk to you guys later. Take care, everybody.